evening, fellow conservatives.
My name is Rachel Luco, and my husband and I are delegates from New Prague. We all have a tough decision to make today. We have to choose between four qualified candidates and endorse one of them to carry our Republican principles into battle against the Democrats. I'm here today as a strong supporter of Rich Drayman, and I'm pleased to nominate him for a Republican election for state senate. Rich is a lifelong Minnesotan, born and raised in southern Minnesota. He went to school here, met his wife here, is raising his family here, and owns and operates his small businesses right here in our communities. Rich has worked in agricultural sales, owned and operated a marina and a restaurant, and now owns his own real estate office in Nevada Center. Rich will follow in the small business footsteps of the last strong state senator we've had in our district, former Senator Al McCray. The legislature needs more people who know how government actions negatively impact small business job creators, and Rich will bring that perspective to the debate. As a realtor, no one has a stronger interest in keeping our community strong and livable. Rich walks the streets of our district every day, working on behalf of his clients, looking to purchase their piece of the American dream. This gives Rich an incredible insight as to what issues are important to the people who live here, and a great platform from which to seek their vote. And most importantly, I'm supporting Rich because he's conservative. He shares my views on life, marriage, the Second Amendment, taxes, education, and many other issues. But don't take my word for it. If you read the letters he sent out, you can see in his own words his positions on the issues. Rich Drayman will serve us with honor and integrity. Please join me in voting Rich Drayman for Republican endorsement. Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Jack Zimmerman from Mecelot County. You know, we've seen a lot of change in the state during the last 8 years of the Obama presidency. But one thing that hasn't changed is the Democrats' constant desire to raise taxes and then waste our tax dollars and create more government programs and bigger government. I think it's time that we change the leadership in the state Senate. That is why I stand before you today proudly to second the nomination for Rich Drayman for the state Senate. 230 years ago, our founding fathers were debating the formation of our government. They agreed that our republic would best be served by a citizen legislature. They hoped that our people would step forward, working in the real world, developing a trade, learning a profession, and then, with life experiences under their belt, would serve a period of time before stepping aside and allowing fellow citizens to take their place and return to their roots. That is Rich's story, and that's what he wants to do. Rich is a fiscally conservative business owner who has stepped forward to serve our state. He understands our values. He understands the value of a dollar and why we need to control the state spending and keep taxes low. As a husband and a father of two, Rich shares a pro-life, pro-family, and Second Amendment values as I do. Rich is a candidate who will live out his faith and never shy from fighting for our shared conservative principles. Rich will bring a new vision and a new choice, a new voice to the state capitol. Please join me in supporting Rich Drayman to be our next state senator.
We are here today to participate in our democracy. And because we believe in freedom, individual liberty, and personal responsibility, but also because we know our state and our nation is at a crossroads. And while every election determines which direction our country or state goes, I think this year is even more so, with the so box or soap opera on the national level, and then, of course, the state challenges that are facing us. And while every year we get deeper and deeper in debt here in Minnesota, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Rich Strayheim, and I live in Washington Township in Le Sueur County, and I'm here tonight to ask for your vote for the endorsement for a Republican candidate for State Senate for District 20. Since announcing my campaign, I've worked hard to get to know a lot of you. I've called, emailed, knocked on some doors, went to a lot of meetings, and caucus night, BPOUs, and I appreciate everybody's support and encouragement. It is my first time running, as you can probably tell. But I believe strongly that we need to make some changes, and I believe I am the guy that can do that or help bring that along. I want to take a moment to thank Mark and Bruce and Danny. We go to a lot of the same, obviously we go to the same meetings. We're pounding the pavement in the same spots. They've been worthy competitors. You know, I don't view them as opponents. Our opponents are Dayton and Dahl and Hillary and Bernie. But great competitors, and I thank them. It's made me be a better candidate, and I think I've made them better candidates. So thank you for volunteering your time. As Republicans, we know Democrats' agenda is to fill the left-wing, socialistic, big government solutions. The Democrats believe health care run by government is better than letting patients and doctors decide our own health. The Democrats actively pit people against each other through class warfare and tax policy. The Democrats will fight meaningful education change because of an underlying attachment to their teachers' union, while the achievement gap or graduation rates for minorities is one of the worst in the nation. Democrats actually believe families would be strengthened with an abortion on demand social policy. We Republicans have a better plan. It's a plan that supports small business and job creation. It's a plan that rewards risk takers and doesn't think wealth is evil. It's a plan that calls for meaningful education reform. It's a plan that believes small government that will enhance individual responsibilities and personal liberty is better than a huge or bloated government bubble or bureaucracy. As a husband and father and a business owner, I've been blessed to grow up in the freest country in the world, and in my opinion, one of the best states in the country, if not the best state in the country. And I had the opportunity to travel through most of the country. This is why I started operating my own business 15 years ago, is for the American dream. I was fortunate to be able to put together enough funding to start my own business. And at the peak, we had 100 employees between a couple different businesses that we owned. And I learned a lot from my employees and my customers. It's been hard. You know, we've had a few curveballs, had a few strikeouts, but always I've learned and grown from my experiences. And that helped forge the character and who I am today and the challenges I'll face if I'm elected, if you vote me in for your state senator. Running out of time here, I apologize. As Republicans, we own our own responsibilities, and we fight to build a social base on humanity and human dignity. That's what elections are all about. But this election is more than just about winning this one race for state senate. As important as it is, it's about standing up for our beliefs and defending our values. It's about preserving our core constitutional principles upon which our country stands. Thank you. And I want to just take 1 second to thank my wife for putting up with me in this election. She's sitting right back there. Thank you.
for Senate District 20. I know Luke would be very careful in any decision he made. He is a mathematician. He worked at Mayo Clinic for 10 years as a statistician working with clinical trials, and I believe he would bring that kind of analytic, careful thinking to every decision he makes. Very often in St. Paul, laws are passed with no thought to their consequences and therefore have any unintended consequences. I believe Bruce would look at every bill presented and use his analytical ability to be sure that those bills do what he wants them to do. I believe that Bruce is well qualified to represent the people of Senate District 20. He was raised in rural Minnesota outside of Rochester. He has served as a supervisor in Bridgewater Township and currently works on the Planning Commission for both Bridgewater Township and in the city of Dundas. And he represents the Minnesota Association of Townships in St. Paul, supporting rural values in the capital. But what I want to say is that Bruce would represent your values and your ideals in the state, in St. Paul. And I believe he would make an exceptional, hardworking, and conscientious candidate representing your values and your ideals in the Capitol. Thank you very much.
I want to take that skill set to capital for you. A little bit of personal background. I have two children with cystic fibrosis, so you know that I have dealt with the medical system in ways that you can only imagine. I've dealt with it both as a civilian and as a member of the military, and it gave me a lot of practice, I have to tell you. I also am a long-term conservative of the Republican Party. I was here when we were talking about the Tea Party. I know where they were at. I know what they're worried about. I can understand the fiscal responsibilities that we're dropping. We sent too many Republicans to office who promised us that they would figure out how to handle debt, and they all do the same thing. We don't do it. So we need someone to be able to play that game better than they can. And I know how to do that. I know how to follow the bottom line and follow back into the depths of our projects. I'm also interested in helping the rural outstate area get a stronger voice. We need a strong voice because right now the metro is growing faster than we can handle, and they're going to outvote us on everything, and they're going to use their, I hate to use the phrase, but they use their standards of life to drive the rural part of the state right out of its mind. I've seen that already happen. I work, as you heard, I work in the township. I talk to farmers a lot. I'm working really hard with them in Bridgewater. We're trying to figure out how to get around. How to solve the water problems that the Democrats think we're going to solve with bugs. We know that's not going to solve the problem scientifically. We get the results and tell that's not going to solve it, but it sure makes good politics for them. So we have to show how we can do things as free market believers and solve some problems like that using free market solutions. And I'm all about trying to do that for you guys. If you get the chance, I'm going to have a lot of fun up there doing that, and you'll enjoy watching. I've also spent some time up at the Capitol working on open meeting laws, so I have some experience up there. I know how closely you have to track bills once you start them. So I've got good practice in some of this stuff. I'm looking forward to the race. I don't have a large team in. You might have seen that I'm running my campaign at this point on what we call Republican approval. That means I'm not spending any people's money until I have an endorsement. Stuff that it's going to take. If you look at last time this race was run, Dahl spent about $50,000 according to the reports. We did that to buy 20,000 votes. So we're going to try to do that. I'm very strong on social media. A lot of you have talked to me on the phone, but some of you only talked to me by emails. And I apologize for not having reached presume you've been looking at all of our websites and you've learned a lot about the candidates. And so I think that tonight it's just a matter of trying to winnow down and pick one out. Hopefully, I hope I can count on some of your support. And if you have any questions, I'll be glad to talk to you during the breaks. Okay? Thank you.
Is the guy that can do that. In the final analysis, these guys are all good guys. They're all good Republicans. They all believe basically the same thing. But we got to get somebody elected. Who's the best one? Who has the electability factors? I look at Mark and I see a background in some critical areas that would be helpful in his campaign. Agribusiness. Lifelong farmer, grew up on a farm, hog farmer himself for a number of years. Not only was he a farmer, he was a leader in it, local, state, federal, fourth courts he served on. He has the kind of agribusiness contacts throughout the district that can be crucial in winning the race. When he gets to St. Paul, it's going to be obviously a big part of what he does, too. Second thing he was involved in was the home building industry for a while. That's an area which has lots of government regulations. As a small businessman, he knows how those impact people. There's lots of contacts there throughout the area because of the business that he did. Again, crucial experience. Finally, the last few years, he's been working IT in the finance industry. This is a guy that when the whole housing industry crashed, he taught himself basically the IT business as the kind of initiative and smarts he has, and now he's working for U.S. Bank in IT. I can't think of anything more significant than space infrastructure than all the information that we give to the state, which they're the custodian of the university. It's all subject to hacking. Mark is a great guy. We have somebody who knows that technology sector like he does that can help protect that for us. Final part of the experience I like is New Prague City Council. Mark has served in the city council for a number of years, and that's where the rubber meets the road. He's at that basic level where government services are distributed to its citizens. Taxes, valuations, local government aid, he deals and has dealt with all of those things and has experience with it. Again, all that experience is great, makes him a good candidate, gets him lots of contacts, but can he get elected? Does he have the contacts? And that's where I really think Mark shines. It's unfortunate, but sometimes in politics, you can be a really smart guy and a really good candidate, but you got to know people. You got to have a name. Mark Cusick is a name, okay? I knew the
think they just timed out. So that was Jim Cleary, Bridgewater Township, North.
How's this one? Is this one on?
Yeah.
Let's go with it.
All right, so that sounds good. All right, the fair said we have four very good candidates in the Senate District 20 race, and I'm going to speak a little bit about each. The first one is Rich Graham. Rich over there. Rich is a great guy. I would love to have Rich as a neighbor. Hang out with, talk with. He's very good at small business. He'll pick up small business votes. He'll also pick up the Republican vote. The thing is, I don't know if that's enough votes to cover the general election in November. Mark Bartusik's another good candidate. Mark will be very good again with the Republican vote. He will pick up some of the farm vote, but they have been DFL counts or something. I'm not sure he can pick up enough votes to win the general election. Bruce Moreland's another good candidate. Strong guy, very intelligent man. He'll do well in Northfield. He'll do better than most of the candidates will. He'll pick up some of the swing vote. He may lose a few Republican votes, but he'll pick up the swing vote in Northfield. Probably quite well. And then there's Danny. Danny's been out pounding the pavement more than any of the other candidates. He's meeting and greeting more people. He shook more hands than any of the candidates. He may stumble while he speaks on occasion, but that's all right. He doesn't have a ton of experience, but he has the exact same amount of experience that all three other candidates do as Senator Zero. Danny will get the Republican vote. And more than that, Danny will get more millennial and youth votes than anybody in this district in recent history. Danny has a very good relationship with both Carleton and St. Olaf students. And as a Republican, and he'll do very well. As a Republican, we should help Danny. He's going to need some assistance in both physically and his answers and his passion and fitness. And of the four candidates, I think Danny is the only one that can pick up enough votes
now green.
Oh.
All right.
It's all
all right. There will be be a bathroom break once the balloting starts, so don't worry. You ready? All right, ready? Let's go.
All right, everyone, I guess we had a chance to save the best for last, so once again, Dan Patricia, I want to thank everyone of you for coming here, and you're up for the grassroots to try to bring change, and hopefully this time we can prevent the lesser of two evils from being put on the ballot and win this end. Most of you already know that I've done 3-3-4, and like, I basically came up with something at the last minute, and I've been pretty good, but this is the first time using note cards, and otherwise everything I say, I speak from the heart. Everything's real. I don't have any lobbyists or special interests telling me what to say or do. It's all me, and I'm a real person. That's what I feel. And from the beginning when I started campaigning, even before then, when I was considering this and when I got involved with the Republican Party, people have been saying that they're angry, they're tired, and they're feeling like that no matter who they vote for, it doesn't really matter. And, you know, for the most part, they're right. It really doesn't matter. And especially like a lot of you, I can hear a lot about me. Like, I've been vocal against like the establishment and the Republican leadership, and I took a chance to talk to semi-learning leader to time. And I was nice to him, don't worry, I'm not going to be mean to him, but I do want to hold him accountable come November if I win. And yeah, and when you look at those scores on Minnesota scorecard, you'll see exactly what we're talking about there. Basically, yeah, it doesn't matter who you vote for unless we get the right person to vote for. That's where I'm coming in, to be the right person who will stick to conservative principles and be loving to the people, which goes to one of the things that's part of my messaging, which is what we need are solutions to all the problems that we're facing, and what we need conservative solutions. We don't need liberal solutions, we don't need Democrat-like solutions, but we need to be conservative, we need to be consistent, and doing one of the things. And one thing that I'm also glad that a lot of you new people coming in, a lot of you are coming in saying that a lot of people aren't talking about issues, and I want to, first people have been talking a lot about it, and like, I thank you for that, because really where candidates stand does matter. And long and short of where I stand, I'm for constitutional limited government, because even at the state level, I don't want to see them do much. That's one reason why, like, I want to push stuff back to the local communities, local governments, make them more responsible. And one reason why I'm against Met Council, because that's an unelected body, for one. Two, that's a local issue, especially with considering like Minneapolis and St. Paul are just, the word we use for them is sanctuary cities, and none of us want to fund sanctuary cities. We should need to stop rewarding bad behavior. And so the biggest issues I like to push for, constitutional carry and more gun rights. I would like to see more free market alternatives in healthcare, including expanding health savings accounts. I'd like to see more health credit, and I would like to see people being allowed to purchase stuff across state lines. And as with education, we need a competitive education system. Put that back into make it like a school choice thing, because I'm all for that. Let them all compete, and also put the school board back to the people, because that's one of the other issues. And the transportation, you hear that a lot, but it really comes up a lot all the time during election years. And one of the interesting things I like to know about transportation is, you know, Kevin Fowler wrote an article recently in the Northfield News talking about the need for transportation and the fact that Republicans don't want to compromise. Well, first of all, I say we need to make the Democrats compromise with us. It goes both ways. Two, not only that, but back in 2013, he had the majority in both houses, and he had his chance right there, and he wasn't wasting time on a light rail. Maybe we would be in his best in the first place. I don't know, we want to make a light rail priority. And you know, another thing I like to see is, like, when it comes to the local governments, I want to see the audit and get funded to them, because I'm somebody who works at a group home, and taking care of the elderly, the disabled, and working on mental health is something that's very important, because you know, the services are already there. The reality is that, like, funds don't get distributed right, because a lot of these local governments just don't use them for them. That's why I say we need to audit them, to hold them accountable, and if they're not using it right, either turn that back or use it, or either return that or stop funding them. And one point I like to make about messaging, where the idea of this is to try to earn the people's trust, show that we care, offer conservative solutions, and make our conservative principles relevant. We're not going to get every single person to vote for us, but at least we'll get more than otherwise we wouldn't. And after all, the only 1 by 71 votes, which shows you two things. One, you don't care why you're not working for this place. Two, you can be able to do that. Whether we do that. If you're looking for electability, well, I took the time to come to most of your houses. I door knocked and lick dropped if you weren't there. Most of you already know that. The other place I didn't come to were either apartments or you have a gated house where I had trouble finding a place, and I apologize for that. But putting the effort, you know, this is going to require a lot of effort. You can't just mail stuff out or make phone calls, especially in general. So if you make a phone call, most of the people will mail up on each one. So somebody's going to put the effort in. Like, I came down to the Scott County DPOU convention, I had to do an overnight shift, and, you know, that's sort of really commitment. And also, we have to take into consideration, we got two colleges in the district, St. Olaf and Carleton, and based on the results that we had back on caucus night, we had about 50 students come just to caucus, and we have about 5 of them became delegates, and 2 of them sit right there, and we never had that something like that before, and so there's a big opportunity there, and if you're somebody who can get the youth to vote for you, that's something to take into consideration. And all stuff I've done was really just a taste of my campaign for general life, because, like I said, it's going to require a lot of effort, so it's time somebody will put in that effort. And on a final note, I don't have much of a record to show that I am conservative, but you know what? A person back in 2014, Jim Adler, he came out and said that he was one of the most conservative people there, but yet he had a Liberty score of 45 and he authored Minshew, so don't base it on that, but based on what I say, and also look at what I do on the Capitol on MinnesotaScorecard.com and hold me accountable to that. And also, one of the things I would also like to say is, if you want to see more of that, I like to quote the movie The Matrix, where there's a part there where you have a choice to take the blue pill or the red pill. You take the blue pill, story ends, you wake up thinking whatever you want. However, you take the red pill, you stay in Wonderland, and we show you how far the rabbit hole goes, and here's your chance right now to see, show you how far I can go, and show you working more effort and keeping to our principles and making them relevant to people. And that's a little bit of me. In conclusion, I hope to get here and go tonight. I will work really hard for this. I'm really motivated. I got the time and the energy. And I finally know, like, I mean, you know, I may not have experience, but, you know, look at the people sitting in St. Paul right now. Look at their experience. You know that they're not doing very good, and, like, 90% of people don't like them, so.